a story about a raven who dreamed of eagles. It seems that a young raven grew fascinated with the majestic flight of those great warrior birds. When he looked at the stubbiness of his own wings, the sooty black of his feathers, he felt ugly and ill-defined. He wanted more than anything to soar and to feel the admiration of his fellow ravens. Every day he watched the eagles drift over the pine tree where he sat, and every day he dreamed of being an eagle. One day this young raven began to practice soaring. He leapt from his perch in the pine tree and held his wings out straight and aimed for the highest branch of a neighboring tree. It wasn't that far, but he wavered in the air. Still, he made it. The young raven felt huge. Every day after that, he flapped to a private part of the forest to practice. He disappeared, alone, to work on increasing his strength and his range. He got stronger. He grew better able to hold the air in his short black feathers. His flights began to feel long and elegant, with turns and spiraling weightless glides across the roof of his forest world. But it wasn't enough. He needed to be seen. So one day, when he was sitting with his fellow ravens, the young raven took off. While they watched, he flapped higher and higher. They called to him to come back, but he climbed and climbed until he was a small black dot in the sky. Then he began to soar. He held out his stubby wings and felt the currents of the air. As he banked into a lazy spiral, he could see his family and friends below flapping about in excitement. No raven had ever soared before. No raven had ever come close to being an eagle. He felt incredible pride, and he banked even more steeply to show off his newfound power. But raven wings are not meant for soaring, and he tired quickly. Far above the ground, he fought hard to hold the air. He trembled. He wavered. He shook. He grew fearful. The world began to spin. The long spiral became a crazy spin. His friends watched in horror as the young raven dropped like a stone from the sky. Luckily, he crashed into the highest branches of his favorite pine tree. The heavy limbs broke his fall as he tumbled through them and landed with a thud on the ground. He was bedraggled and dazed, missing a lot of feathers, but he was alive. Later, he told a wise old raven about his adventure. He told her how he dreamed of being an eagle and had been dissatisfied with his lot in life as a raven. She listened, then sat for a long while considering his words. "We're all born with gifts." That's what she told him, finally. "As the eagle is pleasant, so too are the ravens." That's the truth of the world. The trick is to seek out your own gifts, make use of them, and learn to soar in that way. That young raven paid attention to these words and stayed closer to the ground after that and began to accept himself as a raven. He discovered many marvelous things, developed exciting skills and abilities. As he grew, he passed those on to younger ravens, but he never forgot the lesson in his dreams of eagles. That's why, to this day, when you watch a raven fly, you will see it flap, flap, and then soar. Find your own chunk of the sky, then flap, flap, soar. Abridged from chapter in One Life, One Native Life by Richard Wagner.